mean, you bet I felt it. I tried to be chill, but you're so hot that I melted. I fell right
through. Me, apparently.
She's the boss. Without a doubt.
I'm the planner.
Yeah, she's pretty good at that.
I get a pretty good opinion most of the time.
Yeah, but...
I'm just the organizer.
Pretty much got everything going on. That's all you.
I have a Rolodex up here that just keeps everything.
Yes, she's probably one of the most organized people that I know personally. And I'm in the Army.
She'd make a good sergeant.
Yeah, nice. She would. No, no, yeah.
Well, open up your mind and see like me. Open up your plans and damn.
How did we meet? Actually met in the training room of the Pearland High School.
I was working as the athletic trainer secretary, and Anthony was playing football.
She got my name. She's actually, I think it had a lot to do with what she was wearing one day.
That's how we originally met. And then I started getting back in with my group of girlfriends from ninth grade from volleyball.
Kind of started a friendship.
Spring semesters when we started getting really close. We started playing sand volleyball a lot, and he was in the training office every morning for treatments. And we just started getting really close.
She had a boyfriend in high school. I could only admire from a distance. I liked that. That's exactly how it was.
This is our fate. I'm yours. Do 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 do
do do do do do do do like her next move and like what she's got to do next.
I very thoroughly cover every base and like am so on top of things.
Oh yeah, she's got a notebook.
I like to know what's going on.
I'm pretty laid back, pretty calm guy.
I'm a control freak.
Very controlling.
I have a control issue big time.
I like it because she keeps me in check whenever she's organized.
To see clearer, but my breath fogged up the glass, and so I drew a new face and I laughed. I guess what I'll be saying is there ain't no better reason to rid yourself of vanities and just go with the seasons. It's what we aim.
She's not a shoe girl as much as she is a jeans girl.
I knew that was gonna get brought up.
She recently had 22 pairs of jeans.
I'm addicted to jeans. I just love them.
I ask her all the time.
I have the different lengths. I have the different washes.
They all go with something different.
I have ones with holes or without, depending on how casual I want to be. I got some baggy ones that are really comfy.
Jeans are jeans.
I just love jeans, and it drives it nuts.
Look into your heart, and you will find that the sky is yours. So please don't, please don't, please don't. There's no need here to complicate, because our time is short. This, oh, this, oh, this is our fate.
I actually proposed to her over Thanksgiving.
We were gonna go ring shopping on Friday.
I didn't want to take her out to a fancy dinner, because that's what it's all been done for. I wanted it to be a lot more personal on just me and her level.
We knew we wanted to get married this summer, and there were only so many dates left available.
I think deep down I knew that she was probably the one, like, back in AIT.
Okay, it's like 2 o'clock. Halfway there.
I told her to get ready.
And he was like, okay, be ready at 4:55. And I was like, 5 o'clock? And he was like, 4:55.
Her first reaction was, get ready for what?
He said 4:55 because he timed it like to be there like at sunset.
Just clean up. And for a girl, that's really hard because they want to know that they're in the right. They want to know that they got the right clothes on for the event that they're going to, but I didn't let her know anything.
And a sweater and jeans, and grabbed my purse and was walking downstairs. He was like, you don't need your purse. And I was like, okay.
I took her to this park that's right next to my house. We walked for a little bit.
And so I kept teasing him and I was like, are we walking to China?
Are we walking to China? Like, where are we going? I was like, this place is like 5 minutes from the house.
I was just like, it was surreal. Like, I was nervous and excited, but not nervous in a bad way. Just like, this is like crazy. Like, this, I can't believe this is happening.
Yeah, she wants to know everything. So I wouldn't tell her anything because that was actually kind of part of it. Because trying to get her to just like, you know, calm down. Like,
the whole way there in my head, I was like, I'm not gonna cry. I'm not gonna cry. I'm not, yeah, right.
Walking in, and I had a specific time set. It was whenever sun was setting.
And a beautiful lake. And where we were sitting was like, it's almost like a brick like enclosure, but the brick is like this high. Like, it's just a little, like, wall. Yeah. And then there's benches, so it's, like, right off the lake.
So, walking in, come and sit on this bench. It's an ordinary bench, but now, to us, it means it's got a lot of meaning.
And he sits me down, and both have a very strong faith. And so, he said that before he proposed, he wanted to pray first. And I was just like, okay. Like, I almost just, like, lost it right there, because I was just, like, really impressed.
I thought about having, like, a plan on what I was going to say, but turned out I was just like, I'm just going to wing it. I'm not going to go into it scripted. I'm just going to wing it. Tell her what I'm feeling.
And he, you know, prayed for, like, the right words to come out of his mouth and, like, God to be in the moment, and it was beautiful.
And then I got down on one knee.
Got down on one knee, and I was like, oh, my God. Like, I knew it was coming, but it was still, like, I felt like I didn't know it was coming.
And then when I pulled the ring out and put it on her finger, she started bawling. And that felt pretty good because I knew that she knew that it was coming. Yeah. So it felt good to see her cry.
And I said, yes, obviously, we're here.
I would say that the world was coming to a screeching halt at that point in time. And it was everything. But at the same time, like, it flowed real well. It was like, it didn't have to be scripted, because it was natural.
It's like more love than I've ever felt. When he, like, got down on one knee, I was just like, this cannot be happening. Like, this man cannot be in love with me. Like, it can't be happening. But it was. Like, I knew it was real, but it was so surreal that I was so thankful to God, like, for sending him into my life.
I'm yours. We'll open up your mind.
Patient with me. Just really important. He's calm, and he loves me more than anything I've ever thought anybody could love me.
Very ambitious. She's smart. She's high speed. She's always going.
Okay, well, he's very strong emotionally. He has such a strong faith, which is so important to me.
She's got an amazing heart. I don't know how she does it. She's got this ability to, forgive people that do her wrong, and she has compassion for him.
The best I can put is a rock solid character, that he's just a wonderful guy in every sense of the word.
I think she brings the Joker side out of me more. I'm a lot more laid back, and I can say I can be myself with her.
I have never trusted anybody so much in my life now that I can just be vulnerable with him and share whatever emotion I'm feeling, whether it be, there's an honesty there that I've never had. Oh, I'm yours.